Mbembe Mahachi by ZITF 2021. I'm speaking to
Kolesani Moyo. I'm the City Economic Development Officer.
Okay, Mr. Moyo, thank you so much for your time. We're here by the Bulawayo City Council stand, and I want to find out a few things about the fire brigade.
Okay, thank you very much, Vimbai. As you can see, this time we have decided to also include fire brigades and ambulance services in our stand, just to showcase what they are doing. But the reason why we decided to bring these two sections is that we wanted to show that promoting trade and investment, you need a safe and secure environment. Of late, we have encountered situations where property has been lost in terms of fire. So we want to educate our clients and our residents that each time they should follow. These are some of the control measures where you need to report electrical faults. You should also understand how you deal with fire issues. Really, this section is about educating our stakeholders so that they know that for us to achieve a smart city status, we need to have a safe and secure environment. And our fire brigades, and they need to know where they find our fire brigades, what they actually do, and we are showing the equipment that they use in dealing with the fire issues. Again, what is important is that companies, they need to even invite these guys, the fire brigades, so that they also assess their monitor, look at their fire equipment, whether they are prepared in case of disaster, so that they know how to deal with a fire. Because a lot of people, they lose a lot of money in terms of because of fire outage.
Okay, so that's risk management.
Risk management.
Do they provide those services for free?
Yes, some of the services they are for free when they can educate, but obviously there are some cost implication in other services that they provide. But generally, it's important for you to always get in touch with these guys, the fire brigade, and also know that your area, the fire hydrants are there, fire extinguishers are still working, all those things. You need someone from the fire brigade to take you through those things.
Okay. So how many fire brigade stations are there in Bulawayo?
Well, offhand, there are quite a number, and in fact, the distribution is quite good. In Kulumani, you can find a fire brigade right in the city center, near Belmont, you can find a fire brigade. There are quite a number. In Popoma, there's another fire brigade which also deals with other SEPA, but I can't say the actual number, but we have enough to deal with fire problems.
Okay, so are there any challenges that the city council has been facing, or even the fire brigade department?
Well, the challenge that might be there is that your property should be identified. In case there's fire, your property should be identified. So, and you also need to quickly report, have the numbers. We normally distribute some cards with the numbers so that at least our residents, they are aware when they have any challenges, they can report the fire to the fire brigade. But again, the most important thing is that we should not tamper around with fire hydrants, because when there's fire, that's where they get their water.
Okay. So looking at the cars that the department uses, how regularly do you change them? Taking a look at that over time, there is wear and tear of maybe some parts of the cars, and okay, we need new cars and something like that.
Well, I think we have good cars, because we have been supporting even other local authorities in terms of our equipment when they have challenges, especially those who are around us. We have been dealing with that. We go as far as Wange, dealing with fire issues. And I don't know of any case where we find that the fire brigade maybe is going to attend to a problem, maybe the car is broken down. No, we have state-of-the-art equipment to deal with fire issues. The only challenge is that people, they delay in reporting maybe the fire, when there's a fire breakout, then they delay in reporting.
Thank you so much, Mr. Moyo. That was Mr. Moyo updating us on the Bulawayo Fire Brigade stations and what it is that they do as the department. Moyo, I want to ask about devolution funds. As far as I'm concerned, now all provinces are being funded by the government. There's an allocation of money that they're given so that they can develop their own cities. Do you think that was a smart move by the government?
Thank you very much. I think it was a very noble idea, especially for us local authorities. We received devolution funds and we were able to do quite a number of programs. If you go to Kadri Park, I know there's a school which was built using the devolution fund, and part of the roads there, they were also constructed using the devolution funds. So again, if you see the devolution funds, the good part about devolution funds, you are able to do the projects that you want at local level. You monitor those projects and you quickly implement the projects. Unlike a situation where you wait for the central government to do certain programs. But if you give people the money, they are able to quickly do the projects. And in Bulawayo, I think from the records, we have been doing very well in utilizing the devolution funds.
Okay, looking at Bulawayo as a city, it's always been known as a very clean city. Do you think Bulawayo is still managing to maintain that status, or some things have changed?
We are still clean. That's why in our vision, we are saying we want to be a smart, transformative city. If you look at all our methods, be it in energy, be it in health, like in health now, we have now come up with solutions where we are using even drones to deal with, to show that we are using technology, new technology. In terms of smartness, we have even programs where we are now talking about recycling of waste. All those projects, we are trying to green up the city so that it will be a nice city, so that we deal with all the issues of the environment. So really our city is still smart and is still refreshing to be in Bulawayo.
All right, thank you so much. We're speaking to Mr. Moyo here at Bulawayo City Council. I would like to ask you a few questions. There's this organization which has given a tender to run parking lots at Bulawayo City. What do you say about the program?
Thank you very much, Tenda. As I said before, Bulawayo, our vision is to be a smart city. Already in the transport sector, we have started with this project. This is a PPP between a private company and the city of Bulawayo. This project was approved by cabinet and we are given deadlines so that we implement and come up with a smart parking system. Currently we are using a manual system and it was not a sustainable way, and it's still an old way of doing things. So this company is coming in to bring new technology in terms of parking. And some of the advantages of bringing this company, as you can see, we are talking about increased revenue to the city local authority in terms of employment, order and sanity in the central business center. So really this is a good move for the residents of Bulawayo and the country at large, and we think this is also part of implementation of NDS where partnerships are being promoted.
Okay, how much was funded or how much was channeled towards this program?
Well, because this is still in the implementation stage, what is critical is that the city of Bulawayo has a 30% shareholding, and then the private sector, they have 70%, and they will take care of most of these in terms of implementation, the equipment that they will bring it as private sector. But in terms of revenue, this is the share. But overall, we look at the benefits that are coming to the city in increased in terms of revenue collection and other benefits that I've already explained.
Okay. You spoke of some technological changes that are going to come up. Are there any cameras that are going to be placed around the city?
Exactly. When you talk about smart systems, cameras, those cameras, they will be there so that The cameras, obviously, they won't even, they'll do a number of things, because you know that it will be now safe for you to travel in the city, because you know that there are these cameras. Even though they are monitoring the traffic, but the data that you are going to get, it can also be used in other sectors of the economy.
So in the near future, are you looking at maybe coming up with more modernized parking bays in Bulawayo, like parkades, for example?
Exactly. That's what we are looking, because what we want to do is to bring order in the CBD, sanity in the CBD. And again, we want it to be easy for motorists. Currently, when you want to park, you have to go to the revenue hall and buy a booklet. But with this new technology, they will be able, going forward, they will be able to make prepayments and all those things. So it's now bringing value to the residents.
Last but not least, we realize that around the city there are some parking lots which are not safe as cars are broken into. Is this system going to bring in some sort of security measure besides the use of cameras?
Well, you know that the moment you put cameras, those people who always do wrong things, they will run away from the cameras. Cameras will play a major role. Apart from that, our own enforcement officers, they will be still there to make sure that your properties, your cars are protected.
I'm Vimbai Mahachi reporting for Zim GBC News at ZITF 2021.